Right, folks, what's the best way of monitoring with your headphones, okay? Firstly, it is not put your PA system up or your hi-fi full blast, stick your headphones on and try and mix, okay? That's actually the worst thing you can do because you're not getting a proper sound, the proper sound that you need. Through my experience, this is what I do, what I used to do, and I find it is an excellent way of learning properly how to beat mix and properly how to monitor. Okay, now then, if you imagine, put your headphones on. If you had a record playing stereo, okay, the volume through this side here, that side would be identical to the volume this side. Now then, when you're monitoring and when you're mixing, quite often you'll see a DJ with one ear across like that, okay? Now if you think about it, you're listening here at a certain level. Your PA system quite often is very much higher, okay? It's highly unlikely it's going to be lower, okay? It's going to be very much higher. Now then, I want you to do something. I want you to put your headphones on, like so. One ear. Now, dependent on whether you listen with your right, monitor with your left, or vice versa, doesn't matter. What I'm going to do is this. I've now got the record on. I can hear it through here, but it's not coming through my PA. What I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly, very slowly, bring the volume up until the sound matches here. In other words, that speaker will be a lot louder, but depending on how far I am away from the speaker or how close is dependent on how high I should bring that volume until I've got an exact match in respect as though I would have my headphones on. In other words, if I put this ear back over here, I would have a proper stereo sound. Both sounds would be exactly the same level. Take this one off, turn the monitor on, I need that level coming from that speaker, the same sound, the same level as though I had my headphones on, okay? Right, so we'll put that on, we're ready, I'll turn the level up here, and I'm going to slowly increase the volume till they're the same level. Okay. Now then, listen to that sound, okay? On my mixer, okay, again, this is going to vary on the basis of what actual level your master output is and what level the actual output is on your amplifier, okay? Because you go line out, auxiliary in on your amplifier, and of course then you've got a volume here. In fact, you've got three volumes, four in fact. You've probably got your slider, which is one, your gain, which is two, your master level, which is three, and also number four, your main volume on your amp. In a lesson, I'll explain how to get all of those levels correctly so you're not interfering and you haven't got a horrible sound coming through your speakers, okay? So what do we want to do and what are we doing? We're slowly bringing it up to number three, and three, in between three and four, that was my ideal sound for this ear, headphones on here, and the ideal actual output I was getting from my speaker, my monitor, which is literally, you can't see it, but I'm touching it now, okay? Now then, you listen to the sound, okay, as I go up from 3 and 4 to 10, and you'll see a difference. Right, that's 3 and 4, listen. Much louder, okay? Now, why are we doing this, all right? Think about it, your headphones on here, you can only hear a certain amount. Quite often, if the monitor is too loud, you can't hear exactly what's going on here. If you've got a nice, smooth level, smooth sound, okay, it's a lot easier and a lot better to mix with. Try it. Again, this is the way of practicing. In your bedroom, by yourself, you don't have to impress your mates, okay, because your mates, they come around, they want to see it all full blast and loud, okay. Don't do it while your mates are there. Practice that, and then when your mates come around and you know how to mix, you can wang it up and start nodding your head. Speak to you soon. Bye-bye.